Amber Bass suffers from retinitis pigmentosa, a degenerative eye disease that causes severe tunnel vision. She uses her guide dog, Truly, to maneuver safely around campus.
I can't really compare it to anything, really, because, I mean, for me, it's getting a whole new set of eyes.
Truly goes with Bass everywhere she goes, but her presence often causes a disruption when people want to talk to and pet her.
They're the person that's distracting her puts us into danger.
ECU Disability Support Services offers a variety of scholastic accommodations for disabled students, but lacks in transportation options.
I would think that we would have more accommodations in the way of transportation to and from practicums.
The only transportation option available for disabled students at this point is a new pirate access line. Stephen Gray is president of an organization dealing with higher education and disability services.
So we arrange it with them so that they have access to getting from their car over at, let's say, Minji's, and bringing them over to Bate or bringing them over to the Spate building.
The Pirate Access Line came about after the new construction, which took away numerous parking options. The purpose of the line is to help students who lack mobility options, but it does not benefit disabled students who need to get off campus.
Well, that's more of a personal need. And it's just like we don't supply wheelchairs for wheelchair users.
Gray says ECU Disability Support Services rarely provides transportation for disabled students outside of the ECU transit, leaving disabled students to find their own method of transportation when they have a required internship or practicum.
So that would be on them by Lyft or Uber or mom and dad or friend.
Bass is a special education major. She was required to attend several practicums for course credit, and one time in particular found herself calling friends to help get her where she needed to be.
It can be difficult for somebody like me that doesn't drive to get to places that are mandatory for me to go to.
Kimberly Stanton is a sociology major in the process of getting matched with her own guide dog. But in the meantime, she's had her fair share of headaches with ECU's transportation system. She says she got left at a bus stop twice within 1 month.
So both times I ended up calling Uber. Thankfully, they service Greenville now, but it's still rather frustrating.
While both Stanton and Bass have had issues with ECU's Disability Support Services transportation methods, they both say their academic accommodations are far from problematic.
All the accommodations and the assistance I've gotten while being down here has been amazing, and I couldn't have asked for something better, you know?
The disability services that are on campus at ECU have probably been my best experience by far with any type of disability services.
Jennifer Hines, Pirate News Network.